Ever since the announcement of the results of elections 2018 in Pakistan, the response by various political parties to these results has been evolving. Although several political parties have rejected these results, in a recent press conference by one of the central leaders of the formerly ruling party PMLN, Mr. Hamza Shahbaz announced the party has decided not to boycott the parliament.
आजाद उम्मीदवार हैं हम पीपल्स पार्टी से बात करेंगे काफ लीग से भी बात करेंगे और पंजाब में हुकूमत बनाएंगे
However, on the 27th of July, the PMLN hosted a multi-party conference that was attended by the leaders of various political parties, the Religious Alliance MMA, Awami National Party, Qaumi Watan Party, National Party, Pak Sarzameen Party and MQM Pakistan. Talking to the media after the conference, the MMA president, Maulana Fazlur Rahman, announced that the conference participants collectively rejected the results of the elections and also announced that the elected members of all the political parties who attended this multi-party conference will not take oath of their membership to the parliament. However, the PMLN, which had hosted this conference, stated that they needed time to consult whether or not they will take the oath. Later on, some media reports citing various PMLN leaders reiterated the earlier stance of the party that they will join the parliament and play their role within the parliament. A blow to the aim of boycotting parliament was earlier dealt by the Pakistan People's Party, the PPP, which opted out of this conference. Later on, one of the attendees of the multi-party conference, the MQMP with primary support in Urban Sindh, hinted at joining the PTI as a coalition partner in the centre. Further calls for normalcy and adherence to the democratic process came from some of the leading media of Pakistan, who hailed the election of PTI as echo of their national popularity. Although the national media duly asserted that the complaints concerning the election should be channelized properly and dealt with accordingly. Therefore, it appears that the political forces in the country are unlikely to boycott the parliament in droves, and after some uncertainty, Pakistan should witness only its second consecutive democratic transition.